Guys, this is Zombies FX. Now this is another tutorial. This is gonna be a little bit of a short video. So have you guys ever like seen an intro template or any of mine and you guys see like that shine look that looks like in Blender, like a Blender template, and you want that like nice little shine? If you're like a beginner at intro, so you want to get that nice little professional look to it, which like the reflection shine or like the shine texture to it, if you guys want that, follow this tutorial. So if you guys really do like this tutorial, I want you guys to give this video a thumbs up, give this video up to 5 likes. If not, it's cool, it's alright. But I've been getting a lot of support lately, and I've been saying thank you guys so much for all the support though. And I've been seeing that most of my intro templates I've been trying to download, I'm trying to download this intro template, it keeps cutting out, and it's really pissing me off because it's a multi-styling intro, and you guys already seen it. I haven't uploaded the video yet because I'm trying to download it to get it. It's taking forever. So right now we're just gonna I'm gonna show you guys how to do a reflection on your text. So let's get into it. So we're gonna add an object and we're gonna have it as our text. And you're gonna go right ahead and go to your text. You can put the text to channel name or whatever. So for the example, I'm gonna put my name, and I'm gonna put the thickness to 10, and put the font to custom if you have your own custom fonts. There will be a link in the description below if you guys want to go right ahead and go to defont.com to get your own fonts. So I have my own fonts in a little file that I have here, so I'm gonna go right here and get the font loaded up. Come on, which one should I use? It's this one. Nah, I'm gonna use that one. Just trying to get a good font for you guys, so I'm gonna use. I don't want to use that font. That font might be... I'm just going to use it for the tutorial. So, once you have your font loaded in, go to Appearance and put it to Custom. When you do that, you're going to go down to your Reflection and turn it on. And, you don't really need to do this part right here, but I'm just going to explain it anyway. This is only for, like, the intro designers that want to just try to make your reflection look a little more neater. So, if you have, like, your own texture pack, template pack, then you guys might know what I'm talking about. But if you guys don't know what that is, I'll leave a link in the description below for a video so you guys can download the Panzoid packs. So, and we're gonna get a normal map scale. If you guys already know what that is, you know what I'm talking about. So I'm gonna use a small dot texture, so when the reflection's shining, it'll look more like more realistic, or the quality look more like more detailed. So my normal maps get dotted normal maps, and the scale will be 0.45 and the repeat will be 0.038. that part is like if you guys want to do it, that's up to you. And the metalness will be, I've been doing this new part for like the Lightroom. If you add a Lightroom with the reflection, it'll look more detailed. I just figured that out and it looks pretty cool. So make sure you put your Hold on, let me put this back to 0.50 for a second. So make sure you go to your texture. Go to your texture. And the texture, I like to use stone or concrete textures. I like to use the stone and concrete. Up to you guys to use what you guys want to use. If you go to Google Images, you guys can go right ahead and type in stone concrete textures. You guys will be able to download it and put it into a file. Then go right ahead, go to textures right here and put it right there. So as you can see right there, the texture's already all loaded up. It's all loaded up. Alright, so we're gonna go right ahead and duplicate the same text, put it into the group, and I'm gonna make the thickness like 8, and then I'm gonna go right ahead and make the Revo on. I'm gonna put this to 0.4. Why it's gonna make the thing look different, it's gonna make it look more detailed. I'm gonna show you what I mean. I'm gonna get a color. I'm gonna use red. I'm gonna use red. Because when you do that second layer right here, it'll give it that nice look to it. So it's like nice detailed. Looks pretty nice. If your text is like a little bit big, like mine, I'm gonna zoom it out with the camera, like that. And I'm gonna go ahead and change the texture to like a, like you can put any texture you want. You can put like a line texture, like a hexagon texture, whatever texture you want to use. I'm gonna use one of the smoke pans packs that I have textures. So I'm gonna use the textures I have right here. I'm gonna try to find one. Alright, I found a texture to use. Alright, looks pretty nice. Alright, so next thing we're gonna do, we're gonna use a Lightroom. Now, if you guys want me to do a Lightroom tutorial, go right ahead and give this video a thumbs up. So we're gonna go right ahead and I'm just gonna type in Lightroom. I can't type today. Jesus Christ. Alright, so I'm gonna go right ahead, put Lightroom, and I'm gonna get a light. So just pull out a light that you have, or like the light part, and then go right ahead and put that to zero, and put the very one to the right of 100, because then the light will go in the middle. Duplicate it, and wait for the other light to load up. One need to load that up. Put the light that's on the very left, negative 100. Duplicate it again. Go right ahead and make this positive 100 or just 100. So like that, because then there will be shine on the front of the text now, like on the whole front. Now, we're gonna go right ahead and duplicate one more light. And the fourth light should be loaded up by now. Now, go right ahead and get rid of that 100 and put this 100 away and put the middle part to negative 100. Because when you put in the negative 100, the light will be on the bottom, pointing directly up. So it's giving it light on the bottom of the text. And you're going to go right ahead and copy the same one. But this time we're going to get rid of the negative 100. Should be here right now. Takes forever sometimes to load up the light. Now we're going to go right ahead and put that to zero, negative 100. And we're going to put this to negative 100 on the left, like that. Duplicate it again. Once you duplicate it, trying to wait for this other light to load up. Come on, load up now. Oh, it's going to take forever, I guess. Go ahead and freeze them, Panzoid. Never mind. Now, once you duplicate that light, go right ahead and make the negative 100 to like positive 100. Once you do that, you're going to see how there's going to be two lights pointing to the corners in the back, which will make it more even. If you put it into the directly in the middle, it won't look as good when you put it in with your effects on it. So, we're not done yet. We're going to go right ahead and go to your text, and you're going to go towards to your metalness. Put your metalness to 1 and your to 1. And they're gonna go right ahead and do the same thing on the middle layer. Make sure you turn on your reflection on the bottom. If you did, you're good. Now go ahead and add object, and you're gonna add a group, and it's gonna be called reflection. Go to shapes, and you're gonna add a sphere. When you add a sphere, put the sphere inside of the group of reflection, and you're gonna go right ahead and put the radius. I like to put it to 100 or 150, up to you. And the horizontal and verticals will be 150 or 200. And the appearance, it loads up. And the appearance, and you can put the appearance to image. Once you put it to image, there'll be like if you put the render side to both, you'll be able to see that the Lightroom is with the sphere in your eye, or a black and white striped image. If you guys can Google images, type in black and white striped image, you'll be able to use it as HDRI or just have that shine to it. So we're gonna go ahead and go to our, we have HDRIs. So the example, I downloaded a black and white striped image from Google to use. So put the close the group as reflection and make sure your sphere is in it. And I put the rotation to negative 12.50. The reason why is because it gives it that nice look when you move around the text with a shine. So when you put on reflections only, there it is. It's all right there. So I'm gonna make a group just to have both the Lightroom and the text in there together. So I'm just gonna put this animation. I'm gonna go right ahead and put my text in it and the Lightroom. So to test it out, I'm gonna go ahead and put a keyframe like all the way to the very end, and add like a 360. And it's done. It looks pretty cool. Like, I'm not gonna lie, it looks pretty nice. So, like, with the light ring and everything, it looks pretty nice. It makes it look more nice and detailed. So, like I said though, guys, if you guys use the normal scale of small dot, like how I did, there will be like a nice look to it, like the small dots on it. That's what the normal map scale does. Like, when you're shining it, it'll have the shape that you used on normal maps that you put it. So I'm gonna go right ahead and add my effects onto it just to see what how it looks. So I'm gonna add my effects. If you guys want to follow me along with the effects that I'm using, go right ahead. But I'm just using whatever I'm using. So we're go right ahead and intensity. Go right ahead and go to bloom. Oh, by the way, when you put on like your bloom, sometimes it'll like be too bright because we put it like a lot of lights around it to keep the text showing a little bit like that. So I like to make the radius like to 0.35 or 25. And I like to do this part right here. I like to make the inner glow the same color as the inner texture, red. And the lens flare, it's gonna be the same thing, 35. Make the same color red. And we're gonna add a shutter. Alright. Now we're gonna go ahead and make 0.100. Alright, now we're gonna play it. So it looks pretty cool to me. It looks nice. I like the way how it looks. If you guys enjoyed this really easy tutorial, I hope you enjoyed it. This might have been a little bit long, but I had to go slow in this one because this takes lots of time and detailing to try to get it that nice look to it. So if you're like starting off on making intros, you want to have that nice detail. Then go right ahead and just follow these simple steps, and you'll be able to make your own reflection easily. So if you guys enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Like I said, if you guys want me to do a Lightroom tutorial for next video, then go right ahead and give this video up to 5 likes, then we can do that. If you have any questions, leave a comment down below. I'll go right ahead and respond and see what problems you're having. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'm ZombiesFX. Peace.
Maybach music. Can anybody out there?